ONCA Gallery is hosting a pop-up exhibition of cartoonist Pete McKee. Don't miss this opportunity to meet and greet the artist, open only until Monday the 17th of June. I had a chat with Pete ahead of the exhibition.
I started creating, drawing, wish colouring in patterns when I were a little nipper, about 5 years old. And I soon worked out that it was the only sort of subject I got any praise for from the teachers. And it was true to form, because academically I wasn't top of the class in anything other than art, pottery and drama, which kind of in the special song, I got one at O level, did nothing for me. So I left school with that, then got numerous jobs. And so finding that path of trying to create and make a living out of creating, I became a cartoonist. I did that for about 15 years, worked for local newspapers and greeting card companies, but it wasn't making me any money. Because at the same time I was as a postman, and then finally I worked at Tesco's, still drawing, and then one morning I woke up like a road to Damascus kind of thing, and decided I'll drop the pens and pick up a paintbrush, and I never looked back really from there on in. I had an exhibition in a pub in Sheffield, a famous pub called the Washington, where all the musos turn up. And it went down a storm, and I just carried on. And soon after that, I no longer drew cartoons, and I just painted. Now, I was about 45 when that happened, and I'd already got 3 kids and living in a council house.
It's like a second life.
A second life, yeah, that's it. Yeah, I finally found a way to make a living out of art.
What's the secret?
Paint pictures people like. So basically I left work when I was 16. I was in a band, and I was going to be rich and famous in a band. You know, I was going to be on Top of Pops within 2 years of being in that band. That didn't work out. 5 years later, I woke up and realised, I have these moments, flashes of, hang on, we need to stop and change direction. So 5 years in the band, I realised that wasn't going to pay off. I'm going to have to go into art. So I did an art foundation course. After the year's art foundation course, I applied to go to Newcastle. They rejected me, and so I thought, well, I don't need a degree to become a cartoonist, quite frankly. As long as you've got a funny bone, you can be a cartoonist. You don't even need to be able to draw to be a cartoonist. It's all about being funny. So I thought, well, bugger that then. I'll sod you. I'll not bother going into art college. I'll just do it myself, and that's what I've done. So I'm self-taught, but passionate. So I read comic books. I go to art galleries. So that's your education. Going to art college, all you're doing is, you should only be A, meeting friends, and B, starting up great pop bands. You shouldn't be going to art college to become an artist. I think what I tried to do with the art style is, because I grew up in a cartoon background, I couldn't really go any further fine art, because I'd never been taught how to paint properly, in a sense. I couldn't do sweeping landscapes, and I wasn't going to get the oil paints out and start painting these fantastic portraitures. So I had to keep it in a similar language that I understood. But then I didn't want to make it too cartoon-like, because I didn't want it just to be basically cartoons on a wall. Because, especially in the UK, the language of cartooning isn't classed as an art form, even though we understand it is, but generally it isn't kind of looked on. Even in like the fine arts establishment in London, they don't see cartoon work as fine art. So I had to sort of play a trick and try not to make it too cartoon-like. So by taking the features out, meant that they didn't become too much of a cartoon character. But then what happened there was that people then adopted those characters to people they kind of knew, because they were vagaries of people. So it looked like your nan, it looked like your granddad, it looked like your dad. So people adopted these sort of images because there wasn't much features, there wasn't much of an eye, there wasn't a mouth. And so it turned from that, really, and I kind of just kept that going. Because I've brought up on a council estate, I'm a working class lad. I spent basically 35 years on a council estate. The only people that I relate to or can communicate with are those sort of people. And so my work's almost biographical. It's my childhood. It's me being a teenager and falling into love with music. There's a lot of musical references with my work. And there's a lot of work where it is kind of the older generation, because quite often growing up on a council estate, it's the pretend nans that look after you when your parents are working or whatever. So these are the people that feature in my work, the backstory to them. And that's where it becomes human, and that's where you can have a contact with it, because they're people that you can relate to as well.
What kind of exhibition you brought to
Brighton? Oh, it's kind of a little collection of some of my more popular works that people can get anyway. but also I've created some new works as well, just as a little snapshot. It's because basically it's a pop-up shop rather than a full-blown exhibition. So I've got a gallery in Sheffield, and I've just morphed that and brought it to Brighton. I'm also taking it to Birmingham and also Nottingham. It's going to go to other venues further on, in either end of this year or next year. So Brighton's a test centre, because the people of Brighton are vibey, and you know, they're culturally aware and snappy. So if it works in Brighton, it should work everywhere else as well. Fingers crossed.
More information on www.petemckee.com. This is Willie Ranieri for Latest TV News.